Hey gurus and welcome. Today, we'll take a look at some of Microsoft's biggest announcements over the past month. Two of those announcements are centered on growth, as Microsoft continues its quest of global domination, expansion by adding a new region and also starts looking beyond the cloud and into space. This is Azure This Week, the show acting as your guide in hitchhiking the Azure universe. On October 4th, 1957, the Soviet Union launched the very first artificial satellite into orbit. That satellite's name was the Sputnik 1, and it was about the size of this ball. Only, you know, way heavier. That launch signaled the dawn of the space age, and ever since, we've sent somewhere around 8,900 satellites and at least one sports car into space. Fast forward to a month ago, and we have Microsoft announcing their ground station as a service offering, Azure Orbital, at Ignite. We went over that briefly in our last level up, but apparently, Microsoft wasn't happy with announcing only one space-based service. Just this last week, Microsoft put out its newest product ecosystem, Azure Space. This is a pretty big announcement, as this goes well beyond providing rental satellite dishes to talk to computers orbiting the planet. Well, that's actually most of it in a nutshell, but there's definitely more to it. Microsoft's goal is to make it so that organizations can access Azure from anywhere on the planet. Through partnerships with major satellite companies and now even SpaceX, Microsoft wants to bring cloud services to even the most remote regions. Utilizing technologies such as Azure Orbital and their newly introduced modular data centers, it's feasible to create access to Azure resources that can be used for a variety of sectors, such as remote transportation, factories, defense systems, and research stations. Using these ground stations, organizations can additionally create Azure Express Route connections, making remote communication not only possible, but also secure. This is especially important when you consider the observational data that could contain sensitive details you really don't want those darn digital ninjas intercepting. Another cool feature of using Azure Space is that businesses can use Azure Orbital Emulator. This service uses AI to generate simulations around spacecraft launches and orbit to better prepare their missions. This can help avoid costly mistakes and expedite mission readiness for new satellites to be launched. This particular feature isn't in public preview yet, but once it launches, I'd be excited to hear or even see what you're doing with it in the comments. I know I'm excited about Azure Space, and it's definitely worth keeping an eye on, as it brings us one step closer to getting lost on interstellar exploration missions with robots that warn us of impending danger. The hills are alive with the sound of technology. Last week, we heard Microsoft announce their plans to bring Azure's newest regional data center to Austria. This is part of a larger initiative from Microsoft to help promote innovation and growth in the Austrian tech industry. Microsoft is supporting this initiative not only by opening a new data center, but also by establishing the Center of Digital Excellence. This is meant to help Austria's adoption of modern technologies, not only in IT infrastructure, but also public government services and drive industry innovation. Another exciting piece of this lies with Microsoft investing in community resources that are meant to upskill over 120,000 individuals by 2024 to prepare for this incoming wave of technological innovation and growth. It's an impressive feat and certainly an admirable goal. By creating two-year programs to train public sector employees and increase adoption of Azure technologies, it'll be interesting to see if Austria will grow into the tech hub that they're aiming to become. The final frontier seems to be calling these days, as we hear more and more about the privatization of space-focused technologies and even travel. It'll be exciting to see how Microsoft not only continues to grow beyond the confines of our own atmosphere, but also how that helps them to expand our ability to use powerful computing resources in even the most remote regions here on Earth. I mean, they've already literally dropped a data center into the ocean. So space being the next big thing just seems like the next logical step. Plus, with all this, can you imagine the spiffy new job titles that come out of this? I mean, personally, I would really like the sound of Cosmic Solutions Architect. can you really use the word cloud anymore when your data is going beyond the clouds? I am curious though. Are any of you looking forward to getting your hands on this technology? Because I'd love to hear how you plan to use it in the discussion board. Excited about the growth in Austria? Let's talk about it. Leave us a comment, make sure you like this video if you enjoyed it, and make sure to subscribe to get updated when we drop more cool new videos like this one.